Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Today, let's talk about collision detection. Let's get started. Collision detection is a very important feature of any robotic simulation software. It will help you avoid costly mistakes. So let's see how it works within RoboDK. So first of all, here you have the icon for collision checking. So here we have like it's a gray and white icon, and if you click on it to activate it, it becomes a red and green icon. So I've been holding on creating a tutorial on that topic for a long time. Before this version here, it was kind of an icon with a kind of a nuclear sign. So here, if you have a nuclear sign instead of this icon here, it means that you don't have the latest version of RoboDK. I would recommend you obviously to go and update your version to have this one here. As usual, if you look at in the description of this video, where you will find a link, a URL to go and download the files to follow along. So in this case, we are at 07 simulation tools. So if you open this one here, you can open 07A collision and inspection here. So this station is very simple. We already used it in the past for teach on target. The teach on target feature for just inspection program process, and even for the turntable or mechanism module. So we used this one twice, if I'm not mistaken. So by default, if you simply press Alt and move the robot around, you are able to go through any object without any warning or anything. So RoboDK won't bother you with collisions if you don't ask RoboDK to check for collision. This is, I would say, a good thing, because if you are when you are programming things from scratch, you will inherently do a lot of small collisions here and there while moving the robot, and you don't want RoboDK to always be kind of stopping you in your process. What you want to do is be able to verify a collision once your project is done or almost done. So if you activate this option here, you will see that now the icon is becoming, like I already said, like red and green. And if I press Alt again and move the robot, as soon as I have a collision between my tool, a meter scan, and the transmission, my part, both of those become red, showing me that there's actively or currently a collision between those two objects. It will also happen if I move downward and I have a collision with my turntable or the top of my turntable, and if I move forward, I will also have a collision between the three objects, so everything will become red, showing me that there is a collision. This also happens if you have a collision between the robot and itself, or between the tool and the robot. So if I simply move joint 3 here and I create a collision between the meter scan and the robot base and joint 2 section, everything becomes red, and if I continue moving and then the wrist and then the forearm are colliding with the base, it will also show me that there is currently a collision. If I deactivate this option here and I go to target 1, double click target 1, and I run my prog 1, by default, like I said, RoboDK won't tell me that there is a collision here, so it will just let me go through the part like if nothing happened. But if I go back to target 1 and I activate my collision checking here and I run prog 1, now it will stop the program where the collision occurred. So it won't let you go all the way with your program. It will simply tell you, okay, stop there. There's a collision here. You need to do something about it. Otherwise, if you run that on the real robot, you will most likely crash on something and maybe break something. So this is not what we want. Now that we are in a collision state, even if you were to try to run any other program, you wouldn't be able, as long as you don't either deactivate the collision or that you don't bring the robot elsewhere so that you can restart it. So like that here, bam, like that. Cool. And here you can see that I'm gonna reactivate it. Here, if you look at the slider only went like 3/4 of the way through the program, because here, again, we were stopped by the collision. Cool. Here you have also if you click on the little arrow here, you'll have a collision map. So this is a very important part of the collision detection feature. We'll talk about that in a second. You might also have a bunch of other options here. So those are related to a plugin for Collision Free Planner. For now, I would recommend you to deactivate it. So tools, plugin, and then you double click the, in your case, green dot here to make it a red. This is a very useful feature, very cool, but I want to keep that for another tutorial. This is a way more advanced feature, and we don't need it right now. We will just use the collision checking. If you open the collision map, you will see here, just resize that, a nice little window showing you all the parts you have in your station. In fact, all the parts, all the sections of your tool. So here from base to J6, the MetraScan here, which is our tool. You will have positioner here, J0, which is the base, and then J1, which is the table, and then the transmission, which is our part. So this section here will help you tell RoboDK what can and what can't collide with one another. So RoboDK doesn't really know the difference between an assembly and two parts connecting, colliding together. But obviously, if you have an assembly, you inherently have a collision between the two parts. So you need to tell RoboDK what it's supposed to check for collision for and what it shouldn't check for collision for. So if we look here, everywhere you have green check marks, it means that we are checking collision between those two objects. So we are checking collisions between the MetraScan here and the robot base. And everywhere you see a green, red X, it means that we are not checking collision between those two objects. So we're not checking collisions between J1 and the robot base. And that's normal. J1 is here, the robot base is here. Those are assembled together. If we were to double click on it, we would check for collision between those two. And it wouldn't make sense because those will always be colliding. So just bring it back like that. So yeah, double clicking on the icon here will toggle between checking collision and not checking collision between those two objects. If you have objects that are currently colliding, like here we have the MetraScan and the transmission or the tool and the part colliding together, you will see we have here those two with the green check mark showing that we are checking for collision and a red exclamation mark showing that we now have a collision between those two. Here you have a button to toggle between between checking for collision and not checking for collision, and you see here the red exclamation mark toggling at the same time. So that's pretty much everything for this video. In the next one, we will talk about more advanced feature of the collision checking, some other options that are available here hidden within tools options. We will have a station that is a bit more complex where we need to kind of fix. So I created a station with a bunch of collisions in it, and we'll see how we can quickly and easily fix that using the collision checking feature. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys. Thank you.